Interview with Shaq Diesel.
I'm on here clout chasing with Shaq Diesel. What's up, Shaq Diesel? So what's next for you? What's next for your channel, Shaq Diesel?
Hey man, look, this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna start rebuilding our own motor, cause we got a couple scumbags in my life that I ran through that I can't trust them no more, bro. So I gotta start doing my own work, rebuilding my own motors. Put them together. That's the next thing we're
going to
do.
Well, Shaq Diesel, we're going to edit that one out because it might, there's some bad.
Us African Americans need to know and start understanding the code. The code is leave their fucking heads alone.
Well, Shaq Diesel, yo, I see your dream car was that 57 Bel Air. What would you do if you got a hold of one?
Said
earlier, man, y'all
let
that go. But look, when I
do my 57
Bel Air, I have the LS
swap, and I
would
go
26s
with a
14
inch lift in the back.
It would
ride the hell out of
it.
It'll be a two-tone.
Got to
be a two-tone. Pearl white with the money green and
buff. That's awesome. And Shaq Diesel, I see you growing. You started your channel 9 months ago. You built from 20-some subscribers. Now you're up to 2,000. What do you think is a direct cause of your success?
Man, being natural, man. Coming on the set with dye boogers, nappy beard, fake hair. All that stuff makes a part. You know, people want to see people natural. They got tired of seeing makeup people, you know, people that's made up. Every time the camera come on in a different mode. No, I'm the same person every day. Same authentic scumbag.
So I'm telling you, I'm gonna grow my channel. I'm gonna tell you right now, I'm from the clout chasing, but that's fine though.
Oh, keep eating, man. Keep eating. Do what I gotta take. I do it.
What you got coming to the channel in 2021?
Okay, this year, man, this is what I wanna do. I wanna step into a comfortable zone. You know, I like being comedy. I like joke. I got a lot of jokes, man. Like, you know, little Johnny jokes. I got a lot of jokes. I just gotta put them back in that storage. Pull them out the store and bring them to the set. I got a lot of the jokes, man. I got a lot of jokes. And then on Thursday, we're going to be doing cooking with Shaq Diesel and family. You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to have like maybe one Thursday I'm going to cook. One Thursday my daughter going to cook. And then another Thursday my wife going to cook.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, but Tim microwave. I don't want to try him like this.
Hey, but a lot of people don't read instructions, though. He can show some people. What's your next bill?
Well, I got a 95 Silverado Stinny Cab. That really the truck I'm really gonna bill. I got my crew cab too. I got 99 crew cab Silverado. That's really gonna be my ultimate bill. So I got a bill, 95 one, and my ultimate bill gonna be the 99 one, the crew cab. That's gonna be the one I really want to put all my dedication and heart to, because it's a real fine truck that's really clean, really clean.
Man, you got a lot of options there, I see, Shaq Diesel.
Yeah, man. I mean, that's how you gotta live, you know what I'm saying? You know, a lot of people, some people live for daily. Daily live. I wanna live for present and the future. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, and what I stopped doing is trying to live for the past. You know what I'm saying? When you live for the past, you stay broke. It sounds stupid, but you stay broke trying to live for the past. And that's the truth. You know, I used to be like, oh man, I used to have 30, I used to have 28, man, and now I feel like you still could do that. But the way time changed for you, different for somebody else. You know what I'm saying? That's what I mean by living for the past. I'm living for the present. If I had to go 22s again, I'm going to do whatever it takes for me. For my jump to look good, you know what I'm saying?
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
So,
got any jokes for us, Shaq Diesel?
A joke?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I got one. Listen, why did the chicken cross the road?
I don't know why.
Because they were building the hardest.
You got that, remember that you a live joke? I don't think a lot of people heard that. Can you give that to my subscribers? Oh, you know, you can change that option. I don't think I got many kids watching my videos.
Okay, we'll do it like this then. All right. It was this muscle dude, right? He was in his backyard, lifting weights. And, so the guy that just moved in the neighborhood, he looked at the woman, and he was like, the guy that moved in the neighborhood was kind of like, you know, flamboyant. He was a pillow prince, a sweetie. So he walks up, he said, he walks up to the muscle man, he said, ooh, wee, boy, you look good lifting them weights. And he was like, yeah, thank you, man, I do what I do. You know, it's part of my lifestyle, I do what I do. So he just kept lifting the weights. So the little dude, he, she, whatever he was, he walked away. As he was walking away, he saw the bushes rattle. He looked down and he said, oh, that's a diamondback rattlesnake. Let me warn this guy, because they vicious. So the guy put his Beats by Dre on, the muscle guy put his Beats by Dre on, he was steady living. He said, I got about 10 more to go. He talked to himself. Steady living, 500 pounds, curling. Snake comes up, diamondback comes up, hit him on his knee, bop. Since it looked, I mean, I ain't gonna use the word sis, you know what I'm saying, y'all? The he, she, the boy, the it, the us, the all of the above. He said, hey, man, what you want me to do? He said, run to the doctor, man, run to the doctor. Doctor off down the road, run to the doctor. Get the doctor for me. Ask the doctor, what should you do? So the flamboyant dude, pillow princess, run out there to the doctor. He said, doctor, my friend just got bit by a snake. What should I do? The doctor said, you got two options. If you let him die, or you can suck the venom out. He said, oh, open your mouth. Open your mouth, your teeth. It's all your teeth pretty good. So you suck the venom out, he should live. So the flamboyant pillow princess run back, got to the muscle man still had his hand, arms up and with the 500-pound dumbbell, and the muscle man said, pillow princess, what did the doctor tell you to do? He said,
Y'all subscribe to Shaq Diesel. Shaq Diesel, you have to put your card on here. You know, on how to edit and all that stuff yet. Where your card at?
SHACK.
Okay.
SEL.
All right, y'all. Checking out Shaq Diesel. That's a great interview.